Project Overmatch, which is one of the Navy's big initiatives, often linked to the sensor-to-shooter conversation, the JADC2 conversation. How do you see AI and machine learning fitting into that conversation? What role does that play? And is it data processing? Is it image recognition? How should we think of these and how they go hand in hand, if at all?
I think that's a really great question. And I do believe they absolutely go hand in hand. And more than that, I think critical to Project Overmatch's end goals is AI, ML, and autonomy. I know Project Overmatch is more than just an autonomy perspective. There's a lot of comms related with that and interconnection and networking. And we talked about JADC2 a little bit. So I think from a C5 ISR perspective, when we're talking about that battle space as a whole, and we look at AI and machine learning and autonomy, if I'm able to take a lot of autonomous vessels using a lot of artificial intelligence, and I can flood the battle space, if I can flood even the contested areas where there may not be SATCOMs available, GPS may be jammed in those areas. If I am able to use lots of smaller, passively sensing autonomous vessels, and they are constantly pulling in information and they are processing that information, if there are point-to-point comms, because they are close enough, still available, I can create effectively a mesh network that no one knows is there because they are now passively doing their work using all that image classification and that data processing, and they're able to pass it back. And you think about long-range fires and how important that is to the Navy. Now I've created this mesh network that continues out beyond that contested battle space, all the way out to where I can keep my shooters far away to be able to do those long range fire missions. But I still have all that ISR capability, local, close in. And if they are detected, now my adversary is looking at those guys and they now need to start going active. They now need to start showing where they are. And my long range fires are still far enough away. So when we talk about autonomy, that to me is crucial to how Project Overmatch is going to achieve some of their initiatives. And then more than that, we now can use them offensively and defensively, keeping folks safe and away. And then that, to me, when we think about Project Overmatch and some of their goals, that provides capacity. I don't need a destroyer. I don't need a cruiser close in. I can, for the price of, you know, a munition, I can have an unmanned vessel continually collecting data, processing it, shipping it off board. And even if I can't ship it off board, it can autonomously process some of that data for collection later if we needed to go that route. So yeah, I think it's crucial. And a lot of the work we're doing, my team is doing, is looking at how do I now, to me, autonomy is novel. How can I use it in these mission areas? How can I put more processing power, more machine learning capability onto those autonomous platforms to create that mesh network, to do all of the work there, and then it can be passed backwards easily.